이어서 KCTV English 뉴스가 방송됩니다.
This is KCTV English News. I'm Nick Brontes. The governor has asked President Moon Jae-in to issue special pardons for the Gangjeong residents who were found guilty of breaking the law in their reaction to the construction of a naval base in their community. Governor Won Hee-ryong said Gangjeong residents have suffered for 10 years as their community was torn between those who supported the Jeju Civilian Military Complex port and those who opposed it. He said the residents with a criminal record stemming from actions related to the facility should be pardoned so that they regain hope for the future and build a peaceful community. In related news, the province has set aside 29 billion won this year for 23 community restoration projects in the village of Gangjeong. That includes 11.7 billion won in national funding and 17.3 billion in provincial funding. The total is 17 billion won more than what was spent last year. Money will be spent on 8 new projects this year. That list includes supporting the construction of rainproof greenhouses, making the community self-sufficient in its energy needs, and creating an eco-exploration center. Another 5 projects that are already underway will continue this year. They include the establishment of a marine tourism-themed port in Gangjeong and the creation of an entrance road to the civilian military complex port. The Anti-Corruption and Civil Rights Commission gave the provincial government a top score in an assessment of anti-corruption policies. The province got full marks in 5 out of 10 categories, including clean governance, anti-graft measures, the use of a corruption reporting system, and the integrity of its education system. The province also received top marks in the assessment in 2016 and 2017. Workers have finished replacing a controversial metal bridge that stood along the Yongmori coast. The province began to redo the bridge in October. Workers removed the aluminum handrail and the basalt plate stones, which critics had argued spoiled the scenery. They were replaced with artificial stone that helps the pedestrian bridge blend in with the surroundings. Korean soldiers have enjoyed some Jeju Mandarin oranges, and now they'll be able to have some halabong from the island. The Jeju headquarters of Nonghyeop says it recently started supplying the fruit to the army through its Jungmun and Jochon branches. As part of measures to deal with the seasonal tariff abolishment on oranges, 370 tons of halabong will be sent to the army by April. Jeju Nonghyeop plans to ship more citrus to the army in the future and to expand those shipments to include vegetables and livestock products. Seoul has decided not to require a feasibility study for the modernization of the Dodu sewage treatment plant. That means the project can be finished as much as a year ahead of schedule. Mike Leibman reports.
Seoul has released the list of local projects that will be exempted from preliminary feasibility studies. The modernization of the sewage treatment plant in Dodudong is included in the list, alongside 22 other projects. The national government says it made its choices based on balanced development nationwide.
환경, 의료, 생활교통 시설 등 주민, 지역 주민의 삶의 질 제고라고 하는 네 가지 영역에서 마련이 되었습니다.
The preliminary feasibility study was designed to examine the economic feasibility of a public project that costs over 50 billion won and requires over 30 billion won of national funding. The sewage treatment plant modernization project, which is set to cost around 400 billion won, was originally scheduled to be examined from an economic perspective for 6 months, beginning in January of this year. Design work for the plant was originally expected to begin in June of 2020. But Seoul's decision to exempt the project from a preliminary feasibility study means the updated sewage treatment plant will be available to islanders much earlier. If construction goes ahead using a series of turnkey contracts, the building could be finished in 2024, which would be a year ahead of schedule. The residents of Todu, who have now suffered from bad odors for quite some time, have welcomed the decision.
우리 현대화 사업이 사실상 주민들이나 우리 제주 전 도민의 지금 가장 아픔이었던 걸로 저희도 생각하고 있거든요. 근데 이번 예비 타당성을 이제 면제를 받으면서 사업을 추진하게 된다에 대해서는 저뿐만이 아니고 주민들과 그리고 도민들이 모두 환영한 일이 아닌가 나름대로 생각하고 있습니다.
The feasibility study was the biggest obstacle standing in the way of the quick work sorely needed on the sewage facility. And now, with this exemption, the modernization project can move ahead, bringing residents what they need in the area. Mike Leidman, KCTV.
Nori May Park's Plum Blossom Festival includes treasure hunts and flower necklace making. Brighten up your nights at the Jeju Light Art Flash, which is running through March 15th. Enjoy a unique and modern take on the works of Gustav Klimt and Friedensreich Hundertwasser at the new Bunker des Lumières. QAD Natural Park's Plum Blossom Festival is not just flowers. Visitors can enjoy traditional games, animal performances, and other attractions. Korean and international movies are being screened for free at 3 p.m. Tuesday through Saturday at the Jeju Movie Culture and Art Center in Tapdol. The popular and comedic performance of the Jeju Nanta Company is staged daily at 5 p.m. at the Nanta Theater in Jeju City. And now for our long-range forecast. Here's a look ahead to see what Mother Nature has in store for us. That brings us to the end of today's broadcast. Thank you for tuning in, and I hope you'll join me tomorrow at the same time. Until then, enjoy the last of the holidays. 시청자 여러분, 고맙습니다.